Hello, and welcome to Cooking with Spenny. Today we're going to be cooking a CB favorite, Shakshuka. It's a very delicious Mediterranean dish of eggs stewed in a very flavorful, robust tomato sauce. All very simple ingredients. We got parsley, red pepper, feta, white onion, garlic, whole peeled tomatoes. That's important. We'll come back to that later. And then as far as spices are concerned, just some crushed red pepper, salt, and paprika. If you can find smoked paprika, I highly recommend it. This guy sliced up.
That's all Sam.
I'll slice this guy up.
This red pepper sliced up.
I'll do it.
Slice that red pepper. And so these are whole canned tomatoes, which is very, very important because crushed and pureed tomatoes often have a lot of additives and calcium chloride and stuff that you just don't want in your shakshuka. So you always want to get San Marzano whole peeled tomatoes, organic if you can. Open that and then just squish them up with your hands.
Okay. Spencer, you want these diced?
You know what, Sam? I'm going to let you take the reins. If you're a dicey boy,
dangerous.
Dice them up.
Dangerous. But
dice them up. Oh. Love that. Gotta keep that knife nice and sharp.
Love it.
When you have the vegetables all prepped and chopped, I like to really aggressively brown the onions and peppers.
Okay.
Just because I feel like then once the sauce is going, you really get that like deep caramelized flavor. So that's something that I really pay a lot of attention to. Loving the technique going on here.
It's very funny to be cooking to our own music.
I do most tasks to our own music. And then while they're doing that, I will get started on about 3 cloves of garlic. Garlic's the kind of thing where you can just add as much or as little as you want. Doesn't really matter. I think we all really like garlic here at Charly Bliss.
So you add 2 cloves. If the recipe calls for 3, I'll put in 5.
Ooh,
you
know, man.
Just a little cheat.
Ooh,
a little
wild,
Sammy hack right there. Same hack.
And my preferred method for peeling a clove of garlic is just take the bottom of your palm and just smash that baby. Take out all your aggression. The world's got you down. Take it out on a nice garlic clove. Boom.
Just ask for garlic in the green room just to smash.
Just to smash before we go on.
Yeah.
That is absolutely perfect.
Did your guys' moms used to like make you like snacks while you would watch TV when you were a little kid?
Oh, for sure.
Like our mom was always making us like
red pepper
in a bowl.
Yeah, for
just
sure.
Plain red peppers?
Yeah, I love red pepper, or like red and green pepper in a bowl, and then sometimes like rolled up
turkey.
Turkey.
Oh, turkey roll-ups.
Turkey roll-ups.
100%.
Yeah.
Ants on a log.
I never went there, but I feel like it's something that later in life I could get into.
It's like celery, peanut butter, and raisins,
ooh,
right?
Ooh, no raisins.
I don't do celery.
No raisins, and Sam hates
celery. I feel like a guinea pig when I eat it.
It's a textural thing?
It's a flavor thing, to be honest.
What
I think it's just because
with some buffalo wings.
Mm. I can like get down, you know, cleanse my palate, but
I agree with you that I'd never choose celery.
Right.
Ever.
Yeah.
Well, in preschool, we had like a pet guinea pig and we fed it celery, and then ever since then, I mean, I just can't eat this stuff.
Yeah. All of my food things are from preschool too.
Really?
And we went to the same preschool.
Yeah, we did.
Diced?
Yeah.
I can't eat, for a long time I couldn't eat coconut, because I remember they tried to just get me to eat like a thing of shredded coconut, and I
just
freaked out.
Just eat shredded coconut?
Yeah, which now I would love
I feel
to
like
do.
Coconut.
But
also
for
like,
a long
yeah.
time, that
no, but,
scared me.
No one really just like eats shredded coconut though. Like, plain,
as
right?
like a snack.
Do people do that? I mean, I love coconut.
Yeah.
No judgment.
Well, if I like have it in my house, like if I've been baking with it,
true.
Some, every once in a while I'll like walk
sneak
over and be like,
that coconut.
Oh, yeah.
I will eat raw onion.
I will
not
eat
as
raw
a snack,
onion.
But if I'm cooking with it, throw that in.
Oh my god, I made a really good recipe the other night. A tomato sauce recipe.
Okay.
That calls for, it's like the simplest recipe ever. And it's basically just, yeah, those like full peeled tomatoes.
Uh-huh.
And you put them in like a saucepan with an onion that you cut in half. And 5 tablespoons
Instagram.
Of butter. It is the best tomato sauce I've ever had. But at the end, you're supposed to like discard the onion. It's not supposed to go into the sauce. We save the onion, and someone in the comments says, just like, eat it. It's
just
so good.
Eat that onion.
I literally just like bit into it like an apple. It was so good.
We put it on little crostinis.
Oh,
some, like, that's cheese, really so smart.
Spencer, I'm done with the onions here.
Amazing.
I'm done with garlic.
Perfect. I think an important thing about this dish is you want to build those flavors in layers. And a way to do that is, remember, every time you add an ingredient, you want to take a little taste and re-salt. Adjust seasoning levels every time you add a new component. That's a fun little tip for you. Ooh, there you go. Very nice.
I like fun really, tip. Yeah, did I tell you my tip about garlic, when you get garlic hands?
The sticky?
No, so like, you know how your hands will smell for like a week?
Yeah.
So when you wash it with cold water.
Okay.
And then let it air dry. Don't rub your hands together. It'll get rid of the smell really good. If you use warm water and you're like washing your hands by rubbing them,
just
it's
like
not gonna
spreading
work.
It around.
Just get them wet and get the water off. Your hands will be great.
Those hands smell fantastic.
There's no garlic.
Just pure Dan.
But I feel like I kind of like having my hands smell like garlic for
yeah,
a week.
Exactly.
I'll just sniff them for like over and over and over again.
I think one of my favorite tour food memories is probably the one breakfast that we cooked at our friend Jillian's house.
With the Texas-shaped waffles.
Texas-shaped waffles and
scallion eggs with cheddar. What else was there? Is there bacon?
Rosemary potatoes?
Rosemary potatoes.
That's your signature.
That's signature.
If this was cooking
next
with
episode.
Sammy, yeah, exactly. Okay. So we're gonna get the burner on medium-high. And basically just coat the bottom of the pan in olive oil, eyeball it. Get those teaspoons and tablespoons out of here, all right? I don't want that. Cook with your heart, cook with your eyes, cook with your ears, cook with your soul, baby. So what you want is the oil to be sort of glistening, and then you are ready to, they're laughing at me, to
if your oil is not glistening, do not use that oil. That is bad
Sorry.
Oil, and in fact, it might not be oil.
Yeah, true.
You are probably using water, in fact.
I do hate when recipes, like, will tell you exactly how many tablespoons you need to just, like, put in a pan, like, for frying
yeah.
something up, like.
So we're gonna add in these onions.
Is it glistening? It's
glistening,
okay,
baby. Okay. It's ripping, it's roaring. There we go, get that in, these bad boys in.
What's the best song in the album to cook to?
Oh! Best song in the album to cook to? I mean, this is not a bad one, honestly.
This is like, the
relaxing.
Most relaxing, maybe.
Yeah.
Awesome. Alright, we're gonna leave those guys alone for a little bit. Let them get nice and browned up.
I'm really excited, because like, I've certainly never made shakshuka. Mm-hmm. And I feel like I often look at the recipe online and I'm like, shoot, is today the day that I go for it? And I haven't. So sometimes all it takes is for me to see how easy it actually is to do something that I'm like, oh,
yeah.
I can do that.
I would just say it's like a pretty approachable recipe.
I think so.
Yeah. And it's really good for like groups.
Yeah.
Like I remember I had my family over for Christmas morning 2 years ago and I made a big shakshuka. It was a hit. This was amazing. You gotta set it and forget it.
Spencer, oh my god, fuck, marry, kill, network stars.
Whoa! I just have my pick of the litter, just all of them?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. We just all of the entire roster.
Okay, fine. Giada.
Giada.
Obviously, Guy Fieri.
Okay.
And, I don't know, you picked the third.
Bobby Flay.
Nice.
Okay, controversial. I'm fucking Guy Fieri, baby.
Yeah.
I think that's controversial.
I'm effing Guy. 100%. I want to know what that's like. I feel like it's so intense.
That's
probably out of bounds. Out of bounds.
I feel like he would be a great husband.
Oh,
yeah.
He would be a gentle husband, but I think a freak in the sheets, and that's what I want to know about.
I think I'm killing Flay.
Oh, really?
I think
I'm
killing Flay. Marrying Guy.
I'm marrying Guy.
He's a fun guy. I feel like traveling.
That'd be a good life.
Yeah, travel around that little like convertible, visiting the best diners, drives, and dives. Country has to offer.
Spencer, is this some very fancy... Oh.
Well, actually, funny story about that. Sam gave me this truffle oil for Christmas.
Black truffle olive oil that comes in such a small bottle.
So, don't know why.
That's how you know. That's how you know it's good.
We're gonna add in the garlic now.
That's beautiful.
So we're trying to get some like nice brown bits going. That's what we're looking for, and we're getting there for sure. Give it a little bit more time, spread it out in a nice thin layer. Get some even browning. This is a good cooking song, bleach. More waiting. Alright, so now we're getting that browning. That's looking real good. And so, smelling real nice, looking real nice.
It smells really good.
You can smell it.
So, we're gonna just add a bit more salt, a bit more pepper. And then my favorite part of this recipe is all the smoked paprika you get to add to it.
Oh, wow, look at it go.
Oh, yeah. And then mix it all up. It's gonna start smelling amazing in like 3 seconds. But yeah, it like comes together pretty quickly. Easy way to cook for like a large group of friends. Impress a date? I don't know.
Oh.
Shakshuka, baby. Just cook for like another 30 seconds. And then we're gonna add in all these nice tomatoes. What do we think? Does that smell ready for the tomatoes?
Oh my god. It smells amazing.
Is it glistening?
It's glistening, yeah.
Just smile back at it then.
Alright.
Tomatoes should be smizing.
You want the tomatoes to be smizing before you pour them in.
Oh,
that's right. Alright. Get that all nice and incorporated. And then we're just gonna let this sort of bubble away for like probably 20 minutes or so. So we can take a little break. We'll see when the sauce is ready. So the sauce has been reducing slowly for about the past half an hour, 25 minutes, and it's definitely a lot thicker. So now what you basically want to do is make little wells where you're going to crack the eggs. So just sort of make a little home for the egg. Make a little home. So we do that. We take one of our eggs, crack it, and just gently try not to get any shell in there. Right on in. We're just gonna do that 5 more times. 6 eggs in total. Would you do the honors, Sam? Cracking the egg.
Can I do it, you guys?
No, I'm too nervous.
I'll do one.
Is this a nice little home?
Yeah. Oh, beautiful dismount. Whew. Amazing. All right, Dan, you're up.
Not sure I could do that.
How much eggshell do we want there?
I would say just go all shell on this one.
Okay.
That's a little crunch, a little touch.
Nice. Beautiful, beautiful.
And you have the oven preheated?
Oven is preheated to 375. Thank you. Oh, the wild
salvage.
Card.
Wild card.
Do I have to do it?
I would be very happy if you did. Nice.
Is there anything I should know about making this well?
That's looking perfect.
That's
a nice well.
It's a great well.
That's a beautiful well. That's a Wells Fargo right there. Oh my god.
Nailed it.
Beautiful. Alright, now we just got 2 more to do. Do one right in this guy. I would really be happy if you guys were flossing behind me right now. Just to let you know.
It's close.
And then I'll just get one right in the middle here. This is good. We do this every day.
Now this video will be very relevant with the
youth
of today.
We're gonna see it on a lot of Fortnite accounts.
And I kind of like to put the sauce, just sort of distribute it around the whites, just so that there's some nice, you know, division there. And so there we go. Now we're gonna put this into our oven that has been heated to 375. And it should be good to go in about 10 to 15 minutes.
See
you in a sec. All right, so let's take her out of the oven.
See what we got.
What we're working with here. All righty. There it is.
That's beautiful.
And so we're gonna go ahead and garnish this with a little bit of parsley. And then Sam and Dan, if you wouldn't mind just going buck wild with that feta.
Just little globs?
Little globs, wherever.
Dan, you got it.
You got it, Dan. Well, Sam, you know what you can do.
What can I do?
You can get me with that light truffle oil drizzle.
Oh.
I got you. Very end.
I got you, my
Don't be afraid to get your hands dirty.
Usually I'm very afraid to get my hands dirty.
Really?
No. Alright.
Well then, get out of the frickin' kitchen.
Don't drizzle.
That's looking real pretty to me.
Is it enough cheese?
I think so.
Little goes a long way with the truffle oil.
I believe so. Should make it count, baby. Oh, look at that. The form. Perfect.
Ooh. Crack some
peppy on this bad boy. Oh,
yeah. Finishing touch. Pepper. A little bit of salt. And there you have it, people. That's the Charly Bliss shakshuka. Thank you so much for watching.